नमस्ते माँ।
नमस्ते। नो यू आर नॉट ऑडिबल। एम आई ऑडिबल? या नो यू आर नॉट।
ओके ओके
हाँ नाउ यस
एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस यस समवट।
इज द वॉइस क्लियर मैम?
या इट्स बेटर। या आई होप इट विल बी ऑडिबल फ्यूचर। व्हाट अबाउट मी? आर यू एबल टू हियर मी?
या मैम, आई कैन हियर यू क्लियरली।
इज द वॉइस of fan disturbing in my room? Fan? No.
Am I audible now?
Yeah,
Completely?
you are. Yes.
Shall we start
Yeah,
now?
yeah. Yeah, we can.
Okay. By the grace of God, we are here to have a session on animal study and its relevance in Ayurveda. Myself, Dr. Deepika Singh from Ayurvedic and Unani Tibbe College, New Delhi. I welcome you all for today's session. A warm and special welcome to our guest speaker, Dr. Rema Kishan ma'am. Ma'am has done her UG from Vaidyaratnam Ayurveda College, Ullur. She has done her PG from Ayurveda Medical College, Trivandrum. She has done her PhD in subject of dysfunctional uterine bleeding from Rajasthan Ayurveda University, Jodhpur. She is an associate professor and head of department of Dravigon in Government of Puducherry. She is having 22 years of clinical experience and 17 years of teaching experience. She has authored 5 books till now, and one first my favorite, Evidence-Based Ayurveda and Rational Prescribing in 2012. The book for the first time in Ayurveda incorporate the scientific standards of Shastra. You must, if you are an Ayurvedic scholar, you must have to read this book. Second, The Mission of Science in Medicine in 2020. And third, Ayurveda Gynecology and Maternity Care Revised and Update in 2022. This book must be read by every UG and PG Ayurveda student, practitioner to understand the basic pathology of the basic physiology of menses, as well as the pathology of PCOD, endometriosis, maternity care, and all in the scientific manner. And clinical case solving is also given in this book. And fourth one is my favorite, that is Dravigon algorithm for clinical decision making in 2022. After reading that book, I have taken my PG subject as Dravigon. Thank you so much, ma'am, for this. On this book, Professor Banwarilal Gaur, former director of NIA Jaipur, has commented that the book Dravigun Algorithm for Clinical Decision provides excellent ideas, evidence, Shastra Praman, and guidance for the wisdom building in Ayurveda Sahita and Nighantu to be implemented in current Ayurveda clinical practice to get scientifically guaranteed application and result. This enhances the ability of Ayurvedic professional education to form a complete and responsible physician, that is Bishak, in place of merry medicine prescriber. This is well said that Nighantu vina vedo vidvanam vyakran vina an abhyasen dhanuka setreyo hashasya bhajanam. Hence, after reading that book, how DG must be clear to every Ayurveda scholar, you will came to know a well defined, a well example of a clinical case and practical cases ma'am has solved as given in that book. And the fifth one is SBEBA practice and principles and practice of pediatric in 2022 by ma'am and her husband, Dr. Rajkumar sir, is authored. Ma'am and sir both are invited as a guest lecturer in the CMEs which are conducted under Bharat Mission Bhishak. They have delivered 58 lectures till now in different parts of India with the vision of transforming medicine prescriber to Bhishak, a scientific practitioner of Ayurveda. They themselves, in the first time in the history of Ayurveda, has commenced a free online SBEBA non-medicational viral fever first aid program titled Hastalamba. The first aid scientifically designed and structured to facilitate the innate immune system to eradicate the infection without employing any sort of medication from any system of medicine. Hundreds of people from all over the world were healed by this program during the period of COVID terror, and the program is still going on. Thank you so much, ma'am, for this. Ma'am is also invited as a guest of Doordarshan twice to speak on evidence-based Ayurveda, and she has also authored several articles in peer-review journals and magazine for social awareness. With this short introduction, I would like to welcome you, ma'am, again in our This Life. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you, Dr. Deepika, and it was a broad introduction. Thank God for everything. What I'm doing, I owe to God. It's only because of God that such things are continuing. Thank you once again.
It is still a short introduction, ma'am. I have to choose so only important things. So I have done this. Okay, starting our today's session with the very first question, ma'am. Our first question is, what is animal study and its importance in Ayurveda? Is any classical reference for animal study is given in Ayurvedic text?
It's a very relevant question. Actually, animal study as such, you are asking about the relevance in Ayurveda. So before coming to Ayurveda, why it is seen in modern medicine is a question. They are doing animal study because there are two kinds of evaluation of drug in human beings. Like before that, they should be having research in two levels, basic research and applied research. First one is basic research to understand the human biology or whatever it be, animal biology or human biology, and how a drug is working in human beings and animals to understand the basic principles they are doing, and applied research with regard to a compound. An unknown compound is mostly studied first to know the efficacy and toxicity in animals. So that is what modern medicine is doing. It can be studied in isolated tissues. It can be studied, the compound action can be studied in labs also. But why they are choosing animals? Because they will get a broad aspect of knowledge, like in a whole holistic approach. Mm-hmm. It is not like in a tissue or an organ or a cultured cells. In that, it is a very analytically speaking reductionist form of evidence. So they can get a whole picture in a whole living being. That is the explanation they are giving. But 90% of the studies which are done in animals fail in human beings. That they themselves have admitted. Let us keep it apart. In Ayurveda, there is no direct evidence regarding this research which is to be done in animals. Why? Because it is very clearly mentioned in Charaka Vimanasthana. Pariksha. Pariksha is the technical term given for research. Pariksha yastu prayojanam pratipatti jnanam. The objective, very objective of conducting research in Ayurveda is to attain pratipatti jnana. What is this pratipatti jnana? Pratipattir nama yo vikaro yadha pratipattavya tasya tadha anushtana jnanam. So it is to understand which method or what principle is fundamentally correct to produce reversal of disease. Ayurveda is meant for reversal. Swastasya swastirakshanam adurasya roga prashamanam cha. It is not like benefit risk. this much benefit, this much risk. So if there is a risk component, definitely we have to test trial and error methods. Whenever there we are testing something for risk, benefit risk, definitely that requires some prior research in isolated cells. And second, it is not a particular compound that is recommended to be studied in Ayurveda to attain Pradipati Jnana. What is mentioned? To attain Pradipati Jnana, we have to do principle oriented. Vyadi Bheshaja Prabhava Tattva is recommended to be examined. Pariksha is to be done in Vyadi Bheshaja Prabhava Tattva. That is why Acharya in Ashtanga Sangraha told Adha Yadha Amayam Yadha Dosham Shamanam Shodhanani Cha Prayunjita. Yadha Amayam Yadha Dosham. So we have to do Roga Pariksha, we have to do Rogi Pariksha, we have to do Bheshaja Pariksha, and then we have to determine the accurate treatment principle. Research I am speaking about. How we can do research in Ayurveda? First, we have to do Roga Pariksha. It is not based on an unknown compound that Ayurvedic research is intended to begin from or commence from. Ayurvedic research, there is a systematic method of conducting research in Ayurveda explained in Ashtanga Sangraha, Sutrasthana, Bheshaja Avacharaniya, and Charaka Vimanasthana, 8th chapter. Very elaborated way of research. So research is always beginning from Roga Pariksha. And how Roga can be examined? Nidana Panjaga. Right? Roga can be examined only by conducting Nidana Panjaga. And also Tatra Vigaram, Hedu, Dosha, Dushya, Prakriti, Desha, Kala, Bela Vishesha, Linga Desha, Pariksheda. Hedu, Dosha, Dushya, Prakriti, Desha. So what is this Hedu? How you can evaluate Hetu, Dosha, Dushya, Prakriti, Desha, Kala, Lakshana. Lakshana maybe you will observe in animals. But how assess Dosha, Hetu, Dushya, Agni, all these aspects, Desha, Kala, Avastha. It is very very accurately mentioned. Vriddhi Sthana Kshaya Avastham, Roganam Upalakshaye. Susukshma Madhicha Pratnyo, Dehagni Belachetasam, Vyadhi Avastha Visheshanki, Nyatva Nyatva Vichakshana. Right?
Yes.
Vyadhi Avastha Visheshanki, Nyatva Nyatva Vichakshana, Tasya Tasya Samam Kurya. So, for that, we have to invent treatment principle by analyzing various avastas of Roga, Nidana, Dosha, Dushya, all the Nidana Panjaga, Samprapti Visheshas. All these are to be analyzed. First, then what we have to do? We have to analyze Rogi. By how we can analyze Rogi? Again, there is Deshatattva Pariksha. So it is mentioned, it is clearly mentioned that Yoge Reva Chikilsen Hi Deshadhyatnyo Abaradhyadi. If you are not analyzing yoga, yoga means medicine, by Deshatattvas, based on Deshatattvas, you will commit mistakes. Tasmat dosha ushadani parikshya Deshatattvada kuryat chigilsidam pratnyo na yogireva kevalam. Right? Tasmat dosha ushadadini parikshya Deshatattvada kuryat chigilsidam pratnyo. Pratnyaha means intelligent physician. Ayurveda recommends every physician to be a scientist. Research is not a non-clinical enterprise in Ayurveda. Ayurveda recommends that every physician needs to be a scientist. Mm-hmm. Because we have to discover the patient. Mm-hmm. We have to discover the patient. We have to discover the disease. For that, darshana, sparshana, prashnehi. Three methods.
Mm-hmm.
So darshana is okay in animals. Sparshana is okay to certain extents. Mm-hmm. And now how will you do to animals? How will you do prashna pariksha in animals? So it is highly complicated. If you are not getting vyadhi vijnana, everything regarding the disease, what will happen? Again, vipradipannastu rogajnane उपक्रम युक्ति ज्ञाने चापि विप्रतिपद्यते आचार्य टोल्ड करेक्टली विप्रतिपन्नास्तु रोगज्ञाने इफ यू आर कमिटेड इन रोगज्ञान उपक्रम युक्ति ज्ञाने चापि विप्रतिपद्यते यू विल गेट यू कैन गो यू कैन कमिट मिस्टेक्स इन उपक्रम युक्ति ज्ञान विच इज डेफिनेटली मेंट टू डू द राइट डिस्कवर द राइट ट्रीटमेंट Pradipati is meant to attain the right knowledge regarding decisions, therapeutic decisions, what you are going to do in human beings. Ayurveda is a science intended for human beings as such. So there is no reference regarding animal research in Ayurveda. That is sure.
The point, ma'am. Thank you so much for this. Moving toward our second question, that is, in Rash Shastra, for drug standardization to ensure the quality, purity, free from toxin and other things, this animal study is required. Same for the folklore drugs in AIA, All India Institute of Ayurveda, drug standardization for Ras Raj Ras and its hepatoprotective activity. Hepatoprotective activity in paracetamol induced hepatotoxicity in albino rat is seen in Lashunadi grit and its antidepressant activity is seen in albino rat and Pashan Bedadi gun and its lethotropic activity in albino rat. Same for the folklore drug or any formulation which is given in Ayurveda in Dravagun department of AIA, hepatoprotective activity of Rohitak Churn in albino rat will be noted. Isn't it a good standard that the drug on the rat first is tested and further used in the human safely? Isn't it?
This is very, what I will call, it's a very, what you call, mistaken form of research. I am very I'm telling this not to blame any institution or organization. I am just putting the points with regard to the kind of research, what is happening, what you have told in all the institutes. It represents only a specimen. All India Institute, just one specimen of what we are speaking. Every Ayurveda colleges are committing the same mistakes because the standard is fixed as by copying to what is done in modern medicine. When Ayurveda authentic treatises, our authentic treatises are explaining that it is clearly mentioned that you have to do the Bheshaja Pariksha should start from Roga Pariksha, Rogi Pariksha, Bheshaja Tattva Pariksha, Vyadi Bheshaja Prabhava Tattva Pariksha, then Dasha Tattva Pariksha for analyzing the Rogi, and then you have to invent the medicine. Medicine has to be the last. Medicine is decided based on what? Tasmin tasmin kale tat tat adhikaranam asadhya tam tam yuktim artham cha tam tam abhipretya yat kurvanti tat karma. So yukti and artha are the two strong determinants of choosing a medicine. You cannot choose one medicine and call it as blindly analyze. What is this hepatoprotective effect? How do you know whether a medicine will protect liver? Only in a patient you can analyze whether there as such normal healthy individual doesn't need any hepatoprotection, right? In a diseased person, if his liver function is compromised, what we have to understand first? We have to understand why his liver function is compromised. It can be by different reasons. Hetu, dosha, dushya, prakriti, desha, kala, what you call bala vishesha, linga desha, pariksheda. We have to analyze everything. Why in that individual there is compromise? I mean, why his liver function is compromised? Is it because of infection or inflammation or some genetic error, or it is by means of metabolic error or some drug toxicity? What it is? First we have to understand, then we have to explore Vyadhi Bheshaja Prabhava Tattva, right? So Vyadhi Dosha Balagnibhyo Heenam Tebhyo Adhigam Chachyat Ajitnyasita Purvam Cha Guneshokter Vivarjidam Aroga Satmyam दुर्युक्तम अनिष्टम मनसश्चयत् यस्य पीदस्य पागांदे दोष सूक्ष्मो विलक्षते व्याधि प्रशमं न च तस्य कुर्यात् विवर्जितम् काश्यप संहिता. When you are doing research, what you have to take care? Vyadhi dosha balagnibhyo keenam tebhyo adhigam cheyat. Whether it is not matching to vyadhi dosha balagni, ajijnyasita purvam cha, you know nothing about that medicine, ajijnyasita purvam guneshokte vivarjitam. First you have to know about the literature of the medicine, known compounds, established formulations. How we can get the knowledge of medicine? We can get established knowledge from the samhitas, from the nigandus. We are getting different kinds of arthas. Artha means arthamidi prayojanam. What is the utility of the medicine? What is the utility of that yoga or gana or dravya or single dravya or gana, whatever it be? How there are three types of actions: bheshaja karma, doshakna karma and rogakna karma. Three types of karmas are there. So we must have clear cut knowledge before you are taking a medicine for research. You are analyzing roga, rogi, bheshaja tattva. Finally you are choosing one medicine. You should be knowing bheshaja karma, doshakna karma and rogakna karma. Like for example, you are taking yashti hima guru swadu chakshushya balavarnakrit susnigdha shukrala swediya varnya trishna glani kshaya baha. So you are knowing doshatna karma, rogatna karma and beshaja karma. When you are choosing yogas, padola kadrohini chandanam madusrava guluchi padhanidam nihandi kabha pitta kushta jaran. So where you have to apply padola kadrohini adi kabha pittaja conditions, visham vamim arojagam kamalam. So you are getting rogagna actions, doshatna karmas, deshaja karmas. Same applies to rasa shastra. You cannot blindly administer rasa shastra, rasa compounds in a disease. Rasas are all explained for their doshatna, beshaja and rogagna karmas. Doshagna karmas, abhraga, which dosha shamana, vaikranda, makshiga, everything. We have to conduct research to understand, to explore VBPT, Vyadi Bheshaja Prabhava Tattva. Every practical record of Dravyaguna Vijnana must contain what? Vyadi Bheshaja Prabhava Tattva analysis. Then this kind of absurd studies will not happen. We can never Vyadi Dosha Balakni Bhyo Heenam Te Bhyo Adhigam Chayat ajijnyasita purvam cha guneshokte vivarjitam aroga satmyam duryuktam anishtam manasishyat yasya pidasya paga ande dosha sukshmo vilakshate. If you are giving that medicine, even minimum dosha, residual doshas are left. Vyadhi prashamam na cha tasya vivarjitam, that has to be removed. That should not be applied, that should not be considered for medicine. So it is very clear. And Beshaja Pariksha mentioned in Charaka Vimana, you know that Ashtanga Sangraha also, Beshaja Pariksha, right? How Beshaja Pariksha is to be conducted. So it is very wrong. Hepatoprotective, anti-diabetic, anti-hypertensive, it's very, very much wrong. We should never do that. We are doing grave injustice to our science, brilliant science. We are having brilliant scientists. We are having brilliant records of documentation of basic and applied research. We are discarding everything. We are going behind animals. We are going behind what Western medicine protocols, analytic reductionism we are doing. We are not reaching anywhere. This is what is happening.
Thank you,
Dr.
My teacher, that how can we give the pathya pathya to the animal? How can we? So he said, in today's era, nobody is following the pathya pathya. Nobody, he is saying. And as we know that in Hastalamba, we are treating actually patient with the pathya pathya actually.
Without medication.
So something unexpected to the Ayurvedic physician by themselves. Even lecturers, teachers cannot, because they do not practice that thing on their self. They are just reading it. So this is a thing. So thank you so much.
Doshas in animals? Any idea? Dosha pariksha in animals?
I just think about rat is running. So what?
Samprapti, how will you analyze? Panja Sampraptis.
Don't know, ma'am.
And another thing, I think you may ask that in the future questions. I will come to that. Another reason for failure of all this in Ayurveda. I'll be telling that point in the coming question. Yeah. Not audible. Not audible, Deepika. I think you're muted.
Done, ma'am?
Yeah, right.
Okay.
Now audible.
Okay. Moving toward our last question, that is, Ayurveda doctor says we can prove the scientificity of our medication on Western parameter by this only. Global recognition of that formulation or that drug will be given by that Western medication only after doing that animal study. So hence we have to do it. They are giving the reason for why we are conducting it. So what you want to say on this, ma'am?
Acharya Kashyapa in Khilasthana, he told, Asmadabhi aushadatyanam ahu sukshmadaram buddha. So Dravyaguna Vijnana faculties and students, those who are listening to me, they must understand, aushadatyanam is sukshmadara. The subtle most way of highly complex and subtle most knowledge is Dravyaguna Vijnana. So such a knowledge we can attain not from animals, we have to attain first from the science. And the mode of action of medicine, see, mode of action of treatment in Ayurveda, that is what is to be proven, right? What is ultimately to be proven? Pradipati Jnana is the objective of research. We have to prove that there are successful treatments. Successful means effective, not benefit risk, intended effects. Ayurveda says, Samyak prayogam sarvesham siddhirakhyadi karmano. It is not benefitaya kalpade. It is what yoga shamana is the ultimate objective of Ayurveda. Definitely there are different standards. Sugha sadhya, krutra sadhya, yapya. But ultimately the objective is reversal of disease. And the method of working of medicines of Ayurveda or treatment of Ayurveda is entirely different from modern medicine. This point I would like to highlight. How Ayurveda treatments are working. Dravya prabhavat, guna prabhavat, dravya guna prabhavatcha, tasmin tasmin kale, tat tat adhigaranam asadhya, tam tam yuktimarthamcha, tam tam abhipretya yat kurvanti tat karmam. Yena kurvanti tat viryam. It's not active principle, it is virya. Virya is the cause of action of dravya. If you are isolating an active principle out of a dravya, you cannot call it as virya. Virya is that which works when it is innately present inside the dravya, right? Virya is vishishta samarthya sambandha guna. It will become potent and efficient when it is present inside the dravya. When you take and extract an active principle out of dravya, it becomes another dravya. It is a panchabhautik structure. It has its own gunas and karmas. You cannot call it as, for example, Resurpin is taken out of Sarpaganda. Resurpin has got so much of very detrimental side effects. I'm just giving an example. It's not an Ayurveda medicine even. I'm just giving an example. So that Resurpin, behavior of Resurpin, it can cause suicidal tendency in humans. Whereas Sarpaganda is not causing it. So what I mean to say is that when you are extracting something from a dravya, you cannot call that active principles are the cause of action of dravya. In Ayurveda, it is high time to remove this concept from Ayurvedic textbooks, dravya guna textbooks. Why students are made to study active principles? For general knowledge, it is okay. But action is based on yena kurvanti tat viryam, yatra kurvanti tat adhikaranam. Targets in modern medicine, targets are ion channels, receptors, molecules, enzymes, suppression, blocking, masking, all these are their methods of action. Blocking neurons, masking immune system, suppression, all this, or supplementation. This is not what Ayurveda is doing. Tat adhikarana tasmin tasmin kale. You have to apply the medicine in the correct stage. Kala refers to state and stage of the disease, state and stage of the administration, time of administration of the medicine, and of course ritu. Everything has to be considered. Tat if you are doing it correctly only, it will reach its own adhikarana. Tat adhikarana masadhya tam yuktim artham cha. Not by active principle, based on yukti and artha. Yuktim idi ubayam, artham idi prayojana. So based on yat kurvanti tat karmam, yena kurvanti tat viryam, yatra kurvanti tad adhikaranam, yadha kurvanti tat kalam, yadha kurvanti sa ubayam, yat sadhayadi sa phalam. So these are the pharmacokinetic components, and pharmacodynamic components are what? Kinjit rasena kurude karmam, pakena chabaram, gunandarena vidyena. So guna prabhava, dravya prabhava, dravya guna prabhava, all these are to be evaluated in human beings. It's a very highly clinical subject. I will say it is most clinical subject, dravya guna vidyana, because kaya chikitsa, the more focus is on this. Right now what is seen is just giving, administering formulations without any thought of vyadi beshaja prabhava tattva. I don't think, what is your opinion, Dr. Deepika, on that? In kaya chikitsa, do they analyze VBPT, vyadi?
Not at all.
So directly choosing formulations, right? You are muted.
That's all.
Sorry?
Just a drug and a disease. That's all.
That's what. So this medicine in that disease, based on experiences, self and shared experiences. See, another interesting thing is that in modern medicine, they are doing all this for getting some evidence, like of benefit risk, and they will search in the PubMed. They are having particular literature database in the website. They will search this medicine, how much, not medicine, drug, how much benefit, how much risk. What for Ayurveda doctors are doing all this? Do they get the benefit risk in PubMed, I mean Ayurveda databases? That is how they are prescribing? I have a doubt on this, Dr. Deepika.
They are that self and shared experiences. Dadi Nani ke no.
Why do they mimic modern medicine? They are doing everything finally to create evidence. Do they administer treatment based on what they observe in computer? This much data of benefit risk. So we have to choose this kashayam. It is having more benefits. What is getting proven? For this many years, they were doing research, creating databases. So many databases are there available. Resources are available. Ultimately, still in modern, Ayurveda is considered as a pseudoscience. Ayurveda is not recognized in many countries as a medical science. Ayurveda is not a wellness science. It is a medical science. Life science and medical science. In how many countries it is recognized like as a medical science? I would like to know, after doing all this much research, successfully claiming research, what we have achieved so far. What do you
not
think?
Not even in India it is recognized as a complete science. This is a very shameful thing for us, ma'am.
Yeah, we should take the responsibility, all of us. That's what I want to convey. Despite of doing all these so-called active molecule, animal-oriented tissue culture, all these researches, where are we heading to? What we have attained so far? Are we able to prove a single thing, treatment valid, scientifically valid in one disease? Are we able to prove it? It is curable, or it is having intended effects. There is scientific treatment guidelines for this disease in Ayurveda, for this kind of patients in Ayurveda. Are we able to conclude at least one?
Ma'am, actually, the person who will recognize us is itself a person from Western science. So how he will recognize it when he will not understand a single thing.
That's what. So most of the research panel will have modern medicine doctors also.
Yes, ma'am.
That is quite strange, you know. They don't know anything about Ayurvedic research. They don't know the ethical aspects of Ayurvedic research. Ayurvedic research is highly ethical. There are ethical standards mentioned in the science of Ayurveda, right? What are the ethical standards which are to be considered in Ayurvedic research mentioned in Charaka and Ashtanga Sangraha? So they are not considered. So how do these modern medicine or what you call other experts from phytochemistry or pharmacognosy, they can ensure the quality of medicine. They can ensure the quality of compound, whatever it is. I mean, how much pure it is, how much unadulterated it is. Quality control procedures are excellent. It is a need of the hour that we are getting quality medicines, quality herbs. Everything is fine. Up to that is fine. But that is not the duty of Ayurveda doctor. That is what pharmacognosy experts are doing. They know well how they should do their job. Why do Ayurveda doctors need to interfere in that? What do they have to do? They are already establishing quality, identity and transferring to us. Being a physician, our job is to optimize the application, prayoga, right? That we are not doing. I don't understand, Dr. Deepika, what is going on today, how crazy it is. I'm really sad for this. Again, I think you
that is going on, ma'am, on the name of Ayurveda itself.
How many years we are wasting? How many resources we are wasting? How many human beings we are unethically destroying human beings' health? Health of human beings. We cannot do trial and error in human beings. Acharya told very specifically, Tadak karma bishat paschat jnana purvam samajare. You should attain jnana before you do karma. Let it be treatment or research. Karma is of two kinds, research or treatment. It is ultimately meant for pradipati jnana. You cannot do trial and error, administering compound, benefit risk, that statistics, this much benefit, this much risk. Ultimately, what is the benefit to humanity? Human beings are wrongly handled by such kind of research. Very unethical way of going, frankly speaking.
Ma'am, want to share one of my experience that one patient of constipation has came to the Shalya department, yeah, and they just vibhand and you have to give a medication for that, and that patient later when he take the medication, he is okay. When he just stop the medication, starts that constipation again started, and constipation converted to fissure and fissure converted to fistula, ma'am. It is such a horrible condition. That cause of constipation should be ruled out now first. It can be even dehydration. This is not just like a medication and a disease. So this is something going so much blunder.
Killing common sense of students. Students are told, don't think anything. Just give in animals, just give in human beings, observe and collect data. Means modern medicine is not a deterministic science. It is a probabilistic medicine application. They are conducting, it's entirely different nature of both the sciences. Ayurveda is a deterministic science. It is a highly logical science. Cannot be compared, both of them. We cannot do maths with literature. By applying rules of literature, we cannot do maths. Maths is a deterministic science. There are specific rules, laws, theorems, algorithms. Everything has to be learned. So it is a science where you can attain so much of common sense. You can refine scientific common sense in Ayurveda. But what is happening today? Nothing. Killing common sense. They cannot think anything. Their common sense is sealed forever. It is very sad going, very pathetically sad going. Really miserable.
Actually going on. And nobody is questioning it.
No. No one is bothered about this. They are thinking that they are on the right path. And if anybody questions, they are called as anti-science, anti-Ayurveda. As we know, we all are called, when we give a proposal, it is anti-Ayurveda. What is this originally? Who is doing anti-Ayurveda? Who is committing mistakes here? When we are doing science-based medicine, Shastra Artha Karma Anushilana is advocated in science-based, evidence-based Ayurveda. What is advocated in the science? Is it anti-Ayurveda? Is the analysis of drug molecules administering drug to animals? One of my friends, Amla Rasa Hridya Karma, she did, one of my friends in MD, she was doing evaluation of Amla Rasa in Hridaya. You know how she did? In the frog, she did. Frog is cut open. Abdominal aorta, this Dadima Kashaya is directly perfusion into abdominal aorta. So into the aorta of the frog, it is injected and the frog's heart stopped working immediately. So she concluded that Amla is Ahridya. Amla Rasa is Ahridya. She got MD. I'm not blaming her. She is forced to do like that. She cannot be blamed. So Hridya effect of Amla Rasa is to be studied in frogs directly perfusion into aorta. Is this the way to do research? Is it not foolish? Are all of us foolish to commit mistakes like this for generations? We cannot ask any questions. There are faculties who tell. I know there are faculties in Ayurveda colleges in Dravyaguna departments who tell, don't do clinical study. This is in government college I'm speaking. Don't do clinical study. Do something like a phytochemical or some survey like ethnobotanical survey or something like animal study you do. Don't do clinical study. What a big sin they are doing. They are not confident in explaining, teaching, evaluating. So they don't want. They are staying in comfort zone and they are killing the common sense and intelligence of students. I'm very sorry to say this. I don't mean attack any person, any individual, any organization, any government or non-government, anything. I just am pointing out at the facts, blind facts, blatantly as they are. It's high time we have to change or else we lose our Ayurveda.
Yeah, I think it, ma'am, day by day. We are actually...
Yeah.
From this, we have concluded that animal study has nothing to do with Ayurveda at all. As our audience got all the answers of questions.
Let them ask, Deepika, let them ask questions under this. We can reply if they have any time. So next time, when my request to PG scholars, my request to Dravyaguna students, when you are sitting in the lab, you are cutting plants and observing under microscopes, you are doing animal study, PG students, you are doing pharmacognosy. Okay, those who are interested in pharmacognosy, you do that, no problem. But when your right to understand Ayurveda principles, Dravyaguna Vijnana is a discipline not intended to study pharmacognosy. Acharya told very, very specifically, Yukti Jnana stands Yukti Jnana is most important to attain. It stands above Dravya Jnana. It is important to know Dravya, morphology, guna, karma, everything. Because Artha states Beshja Karma, Doshapna Karma. But ultimately, Yukti Jnana can be attained only in human beings, in clinic, OPD setting, IPD setting, Vyadi Beshja Prabhava Tattva, is to be analyzed. Instead of that, you are dissecting plants, you are observing histology, you are wasting so much of hours in labs of observing plants. You are going to herbal garden. Maybe herbal garden is a small part. You can go and see medicinal plants, a very small component of Dravyaguna, to know this plant is this, this is that, to understand. That is basic. Nobody is going to collect medicine and prepare formulation. These days, we are having high good quality control procedures. Pharmacies are there who are providing us ready-made formulations. They are having good quality. What is lacking is फिजिशियन इंटेलिजेंस, व्याधि भेषज प्रभाव तत्व इंटेलिजेंस इज व्हाट इज लैकिंग. फॉर दैट द्रव्यगुण विज्ञान इज अल्टीमेटली इन्वेंटेड फॉर, नॉट टू कट प्लांट्स, नॉट टू कट एनिमल्स एंड ऑब्जर्व एनिमल्स, कंप्लीट वेस्ट ऑफ टाइम, मनी, रिसोर्सेस एंड फ्यूचर ऑफ फ्यूचर जनरेशंस ऑफ फिजिशियंस. वेरी सीरियस. आई रिक्वेस्ट गवर्नमेंट टू थिंक अबाउट दिस seriously. It's a humble request from our side. The whole SBBA family who are conscious of this, we have generated a community of students, physicians. We are all a part of Ayurveda. All Ayurveda doctors are a part of SBBA. We cannot stand apart from SBBA because SBBA is Shastra Artha Karma Nishilana. Please have a rethinking about everything what is discussed. Thank you.
Thank you for answering each and every question. Ma'am is also want to convey a message to the society, that is, ma'am is also going to start online public awareness classes in scientific Ayurveda on Facebook. You can come to the SBEBA, science-based, evidence-based Ayurveda page on Facebook, where all the cases solved by ma'am and sir and other SBEBA practitioners are mentioned. You can come to know so many videos that are giving the public awareness is given by ma'am here. And you can find so many clinical things as a Dravagun student, as a BMS student, you just came to know how clinically we can reverse a disease. It is not just ki you are just treating and treating a symptom. You can reverse a disease totally. You will come to know on this page and you will find so many cases. So closing the session here. Thank you so much, ma'am, for giving your precious time. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Before closing, I would like to add one important point which was not discussed by us. That is nothing but Bheshaja Pariksha. I request all the students and doctors of Ayurveda to read that portion of Bheshaja Pariksha. It is there in the Charaka Vimanasthana. Idam evam prakriti evam gunam evam prabhavam asmin deshe jatam asmin rito evam grihitam evam nihitam evam upaskritam. Up to that form of cognosi. After that, aneyacha matraya evam vidasya purushasya edavantam dosham apakarshati upasham ediva yad anyadavi chevam vidam veshajam tachanena visheshena yuktamapi. So it means you have to consider whether shodhana or shamana is to be done with this, whether this medicine for shodhana or shamana. If it is doing that, whether any other medicine is there which is doing better way of shodhana and shamana, that has to be conducted research in human beings, right? So that is how research is recommended, research is instructed to be conducted in human beings. Bheshaja Pariksha, so it's very important. Evam vidasya purushasya edavantam dosham apakarshati. This kind of individuals, this dosha status, what is happening, whether the medicine is doing shodhana or shamana, whether any other medicine is there which is doing shodhana or shamana better, giving small time better result, intended effects suited to the particular human being, that has to be identified. That is what is called Bheshaja Pariksha, and which dosage, everything. Samyak prayoga is discovered in Ayurvedic research. That is my point.
Thank you so much for writing this point. This is actually a very important point that we were missing. So thank you so much, ma'am, ending this session by this. Thank you, ma'am.